Sure is hot out here. No, I don't mind though. I'm glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
I started boxing at the age of 10 after my father took me to the Golden Gloves, and I got to see the fights and watch one of the notable characters of Fort Worth knock out a gentleman. And after that knockout, I told my dad that night, that's what I want to do. After starting boxing, it wasn't a couple years and I met my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, which inspired me to further my boxing on down the road. And it just took years for me to finally figure out that what his call in my life was. After accepting Jesus, with persistence and faith in his love, I learned as I grew older that working hard and sticking to the job until it is finished and the discipline that you have to get to a place that you're reaching for is very hard on an individual. I believe that we've lost that in this world today, and I believe that we have to take time in order to make ourselves better each and every day. No matter what we're doing, whether we're boxing or whether we're writing a paper or whether we're reading a book, if we're going to do it, we might as well do it with 110%. How about the first time that you're going to ask your girlfriend out on a date? You don't know what she's going to say. Does that bring fear? Do you remember the fear that you had to finally say, will you go out with me? Well, I can tell you that same fear works in all of our lives every day, trying to stop us from achieving what God has wanted us to do in the first place, be set free. But it does come with a cost. There is a price that we have to pay in order to step across those fear lines. It is called hard work and discipline. The more we work at achieving, stepping across those fear lines, we can accomplish those things that we want to set our goal at. Trust is something that I learned growing up that I believe that is a part of every facet of life, which learned from my parents first, but also Jesus Christ. Trust is something that he has given us that is free, but it is paid for with a price. You know, it's time to get up. It's time to wake up. If we do not keep the number one reason that we are free, and that's Christ, number one, men, then we are going to go ahead and drop the ball again. It's time to get the ball, fellas. Let's go to work.
It's time for the men of God to stand up and carry out the work that is before us. Gene Hatcher is now available to speak to your church, men's group, or community organization on the role of men in our homes, our church, and in our community. And in most cases, on a love offering basis. To contact Gene Hatcher Ministries, call 817-657-9914. That's 817-657-9914. Or email Gene Hatcher Ministries, hatcherg@swbell.net. Encouraging men to be real men. Gene Hatcher Ministries.
In God we still trust.
Place your hand on his Bible, and when you swear to tell the truth, his name is on our greatest monuments, all our money too. And when we pledge allegiance, there's no doubt of where we stand. There's no separation, we're one nation under him. In
trust.